guys. So first off, I just want to say I'm not here to knock this woman's riding. I'm not here to be part of that band of people that are standing around the sides of the arena sniggering and pointing at other people's mistakes. Everyone's at many different standards and levels and have certain amounts of experience. So I also think that everyone should be allowed to ride. It doesn't matter whether they're disabled, abled, young, old, everyone should have a go. But my main beef here, if you will, is the use of spurs. Now, I don't like spurs simply because if they're not used correctly, they cause a lot of pain. And I don't like that youngsters feel that to look professional, to look experienced, to have some sort of air about you where you know what you're doing, you have to have all the gear, and some of that gear will include spurs. And I think that spurs used by the wrong people are just an instrument of torture. So it would be there to back up your leg aid, I would say, but in a very subtle way. Now, I must have got the wrong end of the stick here about spurs, but becoming better at horse riding certainly involves that you are communicating to that horse in a way it understands, you know, with more and more subtle movements. So therefore the spurs can work for you if you have got those subtle movements. Now, especially in dressage, when you're watching dressage, and especially at the top level, or you know, even intermediate, it should look seamless. It should look like a union between horse and rider. The leg and hand movements and the communication should be so subtle that to the untrained eye it looks like the horse and rider are moving seamlessly and just looking awesome. So lower level dressage, of course, I've done lower level dressage myself and I can see all my movements. What I haven't done is use spurs, and I've never used spurs. So like I say, this isn't to knock this lady. I'm not here to knock her riding, but I am here to say I do not like the use of these spurs and to point out why I don't like them. The horse is ignoring her leg and she's backing it up with her whip. But you know, surely that if you're a stage with your horse where it's ignoring your leg, you need to lose the whip and lose the spurs and you know, take it back quite a few notches, really. I wrote an article recently called The Livery Snob, and in that I was taking the piss, to be honest with you, about people that use a trainer to train their horse rather than training their horse themselves. And I don't think this lady trained this horse. Just looking at her relying on those spurs that aren't really communicating much to her horse. If her level of communication is that low, and she's not communicating in a way her horse understands, then I'd have to question whether she could train this horse, any horse. Again, I'm not knocking her riding or her skills. She's obviously worked very hard to be in this test. Maybe she's nervous, maybe she's having a bad day. These leg aids, though, are 100 times more brutal with these spurs on. There are times where I can see she's using her leg, and I've got no idea why. And I've been riding 40 years. I've got no idea. The gait doesn't change, the pace, the speed, nothing actually changes. The horse is looking for the, or even when the horse is doing the correct thing, it's getting booted by these spurs. When the horse gets confused on what it's supposed to be doing, she backs it up with the whip. But in the horse's mind, that can never be the correct answer. The horse is looking for the right answer, and that doesn't or shouldn't involve being smacked with the whip. So, like I I said, I don't want to be one of these people that stands on the side of the arena knocking someone's riding, but with this lady in particular, I don't know who she is, get rid of those spurs, get rid of that whip. You have to change trainer because your trainer isn't... Your trainer, I'm not the trainer either, I mean, but something's very wrong here. It's very, very wrong if you need to rely on your stirrups and use rely on your spurs and use spurs to this degree. I don't think spurs were invented to be used quite to this degree. And especially towards any youngsters out there, you do not be needing to wear these spurs. Go and get to a top, go and do top level dressage, work very hard to get there and show all these other people how you've got there without using spurs, and I think that'd be fantastic if people could do that. Okay, I'll end it there. I'll see you soon, bye.